Hi, my name is Roger. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the code, or start with the code for the subtitle editor. First of all, we have a timer, only one. The mode is set to single and period is 10. The code behind the timer we will do maybe at the end of the video or in the next video. I'm going to do this first, file types. We need to have one for SRT files, so you select here this one, special any, so you can simply enter this here, subtitle file, and then between brackets .srt. The extension is .srt. Then you can open and write SRT files. Then we need one for videos, so you select simply the same one. You change the name into all video, and the extension is .star. You can make .mp4 or something like that, whatever you like, as long as your system can deal with it, of course. So that's why I use this one. Then we go to the properties, or well, let's go to the main menu bar. Let's see what this one is. This here is your menu, and you know how to create that. I've done a video about it, so that shouldn't be a surprise that you how you can do all this. So that's very easy how you can do this. Simply use these buttons and you're good to go. The properties, there are many properties, global and local. I'm not going to mention walk them through here. I'm going to explain them and what they are and what they are used for when we come across them. The methods are huge, mostly for time, so we're going to do that when we cross that bridge. So let's start with the window. The window has an open event, so when you click on your window, then you can add an open event over here. The timer needs to be off when the window opens. So timer 1.mode is nil. Now that's very easy. Then we go to the list box. Here we have the list box opening. Now this is how I do it, but you can do it in the inspector as well. Column count is 5. We have 5 columns. Column width is specified in percentage. Then we have a heading, because we like to know what's inside each column. So line number, start time, end time, text 1 and text 2. We need to have a selected line, simply because we want, if you want to change something or delete something, we need to have a selection. So it requires a selection. So require selection is true. You must select something. Then selection type is nil. That means that you can select only one line. So sometimes you want multiple lines, but in this particular case, you want to select only one line. That's what selection type nil means. Colon resizable is false. So you can't resize your colons. If you want to have resizable colons, make it to true. And we need scroll bars, horizontal and vertical. If we need them, they should be there. Then we have a cell click event to make them editable, or two columns, those cells in those columns should be editable. So we need an integer. Selected line is declared as an integer. And we're going to write to it is row. We're going to need this one throughout our program. So that's why you need to declare it globally. So behind this button, property, and then declare it. If colon is 3, then, well, then we like to have that cell editable on which we click. So me, that's the list box, dot edit cell row, comma, colon. So the third column on whichever cell you click or row you click will be editable in the third column. Then we must return true, otherwise the magic won't happen. Else if, or else, you could do else, colon is 4, then, well, simply write the same code and the fourth colon is also with edible cells. So that's it for the list box. The media player, the open event, this is 50% of the maximum volume. I've explained this in the video where we wrote a custom media player. So if you missed that one out, read the comment or go to that video. It saves me a little bit of time. Here, the same thing, look it up in the help file or simply watch that video. This is the play button. So when you hit the play button, it needs to start playing. That's what this does. Then we have to turn the timer on because the timer has to run. So here is the moment where we put the timer on. So timer1.mode is 2. Of course, we have a stop button. This here is the stop button. When you press it, the timer should go off. So timer mode is 0. And then you want the tftimer.txt, that's a text field, read only, look like this. Because you stopped the video, this has to be reset. Let me show you where it is. That's this one. Then we have a contextual menu action. That's the pause button. So here you have the pause button. And all we have to do is turn the timer off. We do not reset the text field that holds our time, because we pause the video and probably want to play again. So it needs to continue where it is. Where it has left off. So that's it for the player. Then we have the slider. We have the slider for the zoom. Zoom in and zoom out. This one, on the right side, you can see initial state. The value is 0. Minimum is 0 and the maximum is 4. So you have only 4 steps with this one, but you can make it 10, 20 or 100. The open event, me.value is 0. That means that the slider is all the way to the left when the program opens. Here we have the text size of the text area. So if the value is 0, then the text size should be 12 pixels. If it is 1, it is 14 and so on. You can simply do it like this. You can also do it with a select case if you want to. But 10, 12 years ago, that was all I basically knew. Here we have TF timer. TF timer, when the program opens, should look like this. Sorry, like this. So me.txt, and then you fill this in. Very easy, very simple. It's an open event, and that's all there is to it. And I believe I'm running out of time. Well, I should stop here. In the next video, we start with the timer.